Well, hello everybody, it's Richard here and welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to push the subscribe button. And also, if you're already a member of my channel watching audience, then don't forget to press the little bell so that you get updates automatically when I'm doing the next broadcast. Today is a tuna day. It's day 18 today. And to keep the coronavirus away. So welcome back, relax, and sit back and enjoy the next few minutes of informed chat and also some very nice tunes at the end of this video. And I look forward to your comments as well. I've received quite a few comments from yesterday's broadcast. Thank you very much, everyone who contributed to that. That's really nice. It's great that I've got an audience out there who are watching every day. We're getting about 24, 25 views a day. I know that's not many, but there are other people also who comment as well along that road. So I've got about just over 1,800 subscribers, which is quite generous, really, I think, for somebody who just does this off the cuff, basically, and keeps the interest going. So, but I thought I might change the format slightly as we get into day 19, 20, and so forth, depending how long these coronavirus tuna days are going to be going on, and talk about some of the other things, perhaps by box sets, perhaps individual types of music, genres of music, that, and then I'll play some tunes from that. But before then, I thought I'd just mention the press, like I always do, and the Telegraph is reporting that half of Europe's deaths are, would you believe, in care homes. The World Health Organization is quite concerned about it, actually, and in fact, they say they're deeply concerned about the picture in care homes. In the UK, we've got 18,000 deaths now, and I expect today there'll be another increase as well in the briefing that takes place at 5 o'clock today that I was tuned into. Some of the questions that come from the press tend to be repeated these days, so I've really sort of stopped watching all of it, but it's informative all the same. And then in the middle of the day, the Scottish First Minister also gives an update, Nicola Sturgeon, and also from her team. So it's interesting what's happening in other parts of the country too. So one very concerned chief executive, Jeremy Richardson, the chief executive of Four Seasons Healthcare, one of the larger organisations within the United Kingdom here, is quite worrying, and that 240 of his residents have died out of 187 homes. So it's quite a large organisation. That's quite a large proportion. And it could mean that we have a scaling up of about 24,000 deaths in care homes. The reason I mention care homes quite often is that there seem to be a second class relation to National Health Service hospitals. It's like the National Health Service has suddenly become a new religion, which is, you know, with clapping and banging of saucepans on Thursdays for key workers. And I don't disagree with that, but I do believe that you know, there needs to be some press given to care homes as well, and I mentioned that when I was on a Zoom conference with colleagues only the other day. But and also because I work within that sector, I suppose I have a bit of an interest. But anyway, today's been another very nice day, quite warm. Been sitting in the garden on occasion for lunch, and I've also finished the waxing or carpet washing of the house now. This floor, this room has been done, and I'll post some pictures of my vax machine next to number 73, and I've now moved on to doing some of the furniture as well, because there's an attachment that you can use that you can actually clean the furniture as well. I hadn't used it before, but I thought I'd try it out today as the weather's so nice. So I also thought I'd mention to you that yesterday I reviewed some DVDs. Last night I watched the Robert De Niro film The Joker. And I have to say, it was quite disturbing. It is a 15, which says here, strong, bloody violence and language. And certainly there was plenty of bloody violence in there. It's certainly not for the faint-hearted, this one. Certainly don't watch it before you go to bed. At least I did, and I don't believe I woke up thinking about some of the things he was doing. It features, the main sort of feature about it is a story about a guy who was dressed up as a clown, working as a clown, where the shop was closing down. He got abused by some youths, and then you know, because of that, it altered his mind about people. His mother also isn't very well, and he's looking after her. And well, I won't spoil the end of the story, but you can imagine how it digresses, and he ends up, you know, really, you know, is he bad or is he mad? And it's on that basis. But I stuck with it because I did think about turning it off at one time. But it's certainly not the sort of movie that I normally would like to watch. As I say, I have got Star Wars, Luke Skywalker, so I'm hoping that's going to be slightly different. And I quite like Wi-Fi. No, Wi-Fi? No, sci-fi. That's the word. Get my... Yeah, it's always best to engage the brain before you open your mouth. And I think I must need to do that. So, yes. And the other thing is that one of my viewers quite like Victoria and Abdul, and they quite like that as well. And I've replied to their comment on the box yesterday. I think that's a very nice movie, and certainly one that I will be watching again. I give it a 10 out of 10, actually, on the Richter scale, as I used to call it, and that's good. It's a good one. The Joker, not so keen on that. Probably won't hang on to that one. Might give it away, actually, to a charity shop, maybe. But if anyone would like it, you're very welcome to let me know. And if it's within reason of the post, then I'll send it to you free of charge. Perhaps you could just refund my postage for me somehow. But, you know, it's certainly not going to be watched again in my household. So there we go. There are the two videos, DVD videos, I thought I'd share with you. DVDs as opposed to videos. But today I thought I'd pay tribute to this lady. Vera Lynn is 103 and she is the Force's sweetheart. Though I know Catherine Jenkins has really taken that mantle now. But Vera, you know, we pay tribute to her. 103, I mean, that's quite an amazing achievement. She's still living at home, as far as I know. So I've done a couple of things. There's a couple of tracks from this album, which are, where are we? The Gathering of the Clans and Alveda Zane's Sweetheart are played on here. And so I thought it would be nice to do that. This is a very nice record. As you know, I prefer Anne Shelton, but some of Vera's songs are very nice. And I think this, because of the age of this album, it's sort of late 50s, early 60s. It's on a flip back. And it's on the Ace of Clubs label. I held on to this. I originally had a copy that was very worn, and so I looked out for another one. Didn't find one on eBay, but I then found one in the local charity shop only a short time ago, so I was really happy about that. So I've kept the second copy anyway, but some really nice songs on here. To complement this, I thought perhaps I would also play the Desmond Carrington recording, or part of it, very part of it, that he talks to Vera. And she's in her 90s then, so that's going back quite a way from 103. So and I recorded that, as you know, back in 2009. So, but I thought you'd enjoy that. And I've also been told off by one of my Facebook friends for apologising for the bad reception on the tape from the radio. And so I'm not going to do that again. But thank you anyway, Rob, for your comments. I really appreciate that. And I'm hoping that people's enjoyment hasn't been damaged in any way. But see what you think and let me know. Look forward to your comments anyway. So that's all for today. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Enjoy the rest of my broadcast. And enjoy Vera Lynn. And enjoy Desmond Carrington. And until tomorrow, when I'll be celebrating day 19, Saturday the 25th, day 19, all the very best, stay safe, and also look forward to your comments and seeing you tomorrow. All the best. Vera Lynn's selection, Vera's greatest chorus hits, Vera Lynn and Chorus with the Armed Forces.
Healing. again, like this again. Don't let the teardrops start. With love that's true, I'll wait for you.
First broadcast 4 years ago. For it, I was able to talk to a lady who was born in London 1 year before the end of the Great War and who grew up to become the sweetheart of the forces during World War II. At the time we spoke, she was in her 80s. She is now 92. And my reason for repeating the program is that a collection of her songs recently went to the very top of the British album charts, and that tells you how much she is loved by us all. So let me refresh our memories of the extraordinary career of Dame Vera Lynn.
Once upon a time, there was a tavern where we used to raise a glass or two. Remember how we locked away the hours and dreamed all of the great things we would do. Those were the days, my friend. We thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we choose. We'd fight and never lose, for we were young and sure to have our way. La 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 la. Those were the days. Oh yes, those were the days. Then the busy years went rushing by us. We lost our starry notions on the way. If by chance I'd see you in the tavern, we'd smile at one another and we'd say, those were the days, my friend. We thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We live the life we choose. We fight and never lose, for we were young and sure to have our way. La 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 la. Those were the days. Oh yes, those were the days.
Those were the days. and Vera Lynn, now in her 90s, can look back on a lifetime's memories. We're chatting at Vera's home in Sussex, and despite the fact that she has her arm in a sling from an accident to her head, it didn't cloud my welcome, and I know it's not going to stem the recollections. First of which, of course, Vera, is how did it all begin back in the late 20s?
It's around Grandma's house, you know, like we did in those days. We used to sing our little songs, and a friend of the family who was an entertainer heard me and said, can I take Vera to one of my concerts, which was in a working man's club? And my mother said yes, and I was 7 at the time, and that was the first time that I actually sang on a stage in public.
Can you remember your first professional appearance then?
Well, that was
7.
I got paid 7 shillings and 6 pence.
Oh. How did that lead on to singing with dance bands and things?
Well, I continued singing at clubs and social evenings and joined a juvenile troupe, you know, like children did, and we used to perform at cinemas during the school holidays, in between the films. And then when I was 16, I started singing with bands, local dance bands, gig bands.
And what about the big name bands? I mean, the ones that we recognise?
That wasn't till about 1935, when I did some broadcasts with Joe Loss. And I started recording then, Sixpenny Records from Woolworths. Cinder Tell a Lie, Red Sails in the Sunset. Yes, there were a couple of the ones that I remember.
He sailed at the dawning. All day I've been blue. Red sails in the sunset. I'm trusting in you. Wings you must borrow, make straight for the shore. We marry tomorrow.